Welcome back to a new tutorial, Benoît Farine for Ben Explorer. In this module, we will go over the components and the panels that you'll be using most often while editing a project. So I have Premiere running already. Let's create a new project. Choose File, New Project, and in the New Project dialog, for the name of the project, I will enter Essentials, and I will save the project on my desktop in the My Projects folder. I won't go through the defaults of this dialog. We covered this in a previous module, so if you need more information on the project settings, check the module Start Screen and Create a New Project. From here, just click OK. We'll now import some media in order to see how to interact with the interface components. Open the media panel, navigate to the tutorial files. We will import three video files. Go to the video folder and select Bikers and a Car. Now hit Ctrl or Command on the back and click on Daytime Bikers and finally on Mountain Bike in the Forest. Now right-click on any of the three files and select Import. Before we move on, make sure that the editing workspace is selected. You can see here in the Windows workspaces if it is selected, or here in the Workspaces bar. And if it isn't, then just select Editing from the Workspaces bar. Now we see several panels here. On the bottom left, we have the Project panel. The project panel displays all the media files that have been loaded to our project. Video files, image files, and audio files are listed here. We only imported three videos, so the project panel is not too busy, but as we add more and more files, we will need to eventually organize these files to keep things manageable. I'll show you how to organize our clips shortly. Each panel has its own menu and menu options. To access a menu, click on the icon on the right side of the panel name, and the panel menu shows up. The menu we see here contains options that are specific to the project panel, so each panel has its own menu options. The project panel is one of several panels forming a panel group. In a group, like this group for example, panels are displayed as tabs. Panels can also be stacked. To change from a tabbed view to a stacked view, click any of the panel menus, open the panel group settings, and tick Stacked Panel Group. Notice that the group panels are now stacked, and to expand or collapse a panel, all I need to do is click on it. We will switch back to a tabbed state. Select the menu icon, open panel group settings, and untick Stacked Panel Group. Depending on your screen resolution, and the width of the group, and the number of panels in the group, there may be insufficient space to represent them all as tabs. Click this icon to access additional panels. We can notice that the panel markers and the panel history do not show in the list of tabs. Let's select Markers. Markers now shows as a tab, but Project Panel was removed to make some space for the new panel we just selected. To go back to the Project Panel, just click on the side menu and select it from the list. This is the timeline panel. Clips, video clips, images, audio clips are dropped on the timeline panel to form a sequence. The panel is empty now, so let's add a few clips. I'll select Daytime Bikers from the project panel and drag it on the V1 channel on the timeline. Premiere created a new sequence for us, and a preview of the clip shows in the program monitor. Let's add a second clip. Select Mountain Bike in the Forest and place it just after the first clip. If you make a mistake, just click Ctrl-Z or Option-Z on the Mac to undo and drag the clip over again. On the timeline, we can add video clips, images, and audio clips. This is also where we'll be cutting clips, we'll be moving clips around, we'll be adding transitions between clips. Basically, editing activities are done on the timeline. We will look into this in a later tutorial. On the top right, we have the program monitor. The program monitor is a preview of the sequence that we are building on the timeline. If I move the cursor on the timeline, we can see a preview of the clip at the time of the cursor. What we see here is the frame of this clip at this time. The program monitor will also preview the effects that are applied to clips. We will study and apply effects in a later tutorial. The top left area is the source monitor. The source monitor looks quite similar to the program monitor, but it plays a different purpose. The source monitor previews a single video clip, while the program monitor previews the whole sequence. The clip that is shown in the source monitor can either be one of the clips of the sequence, for example, double-click on the last clip of the sequence and notice it opens in the source monitor. It can also be one of the clips we imported. Double-click here on Bikers and a Car in the project panel, and the clip now shows in the source monitor. So as I scrub the playhead on the source monitor, I can preview the content of the clip. The source monitor is also used for preparing a clip. For example, we might want to trim a portion of the clip before the clip gets added to the timeline. We will study this as well in a future tutorial. Here we have the Tools panel. This panel provides a list of the tools that we will be using in the sequence. We'll use them extensively to edit our clips. For example, the Selection tool selects clips on the timeline. The Track Select tool selects clips on multiple tracks. The Razor tool creates new edit points on a clip. So basically, we first select a tool in the tool panel to then exercise an action on a clip in the sequence. We will cover tools in a later tutorial as well. On the far right down here, we have the Audio Meter panel. This panel shows the audio level of the clip that is currently running within the sequence. Okay, now let's see these panels in action. I'll hit the play button on the timeline. This plays the clips that we've assembled on the sequence. Videos here and the audio on this channel. The preview shows here in the program monitor, and the audio levels are displayed in the audio meter panel. This module provides a quick overview of the main components. We will go much deeper into using these components in next modules. In this module, we went over the main components of the editing workspace. The project panel shows the media that we imported to our project. The timeline panel assembles our clips and manages our sequence. The program monitor previews the sequence that is built on the timeline. The source monitor previews imported clips and prepares clips prior to adding them to the timeline. The Tools panel executes actions on the clips in the sequence. The Audio Meter panel shows the audio levels of the clips in the sequence. In the next module, we will look a little deeper into the Project panel, and I'll show you how to organize your media. The Project panel also provides a lot of valuable information about the metadata that is extracted from your media files.